In Syria, there are individuals and organizations who ordered or carried out attacks and torture against their own people, made or used chemical weapons, or built their personal fortune thanks to the war. EU sanctions are designed in a way that only targets these people and these activities, avoiding negative impact on the population. The EU started sanctioning these people as early as 2011. 273 such individuals and 70 such entities fall under EU sanctions. Most Syrians know who they are and what they did. These people are banned from traveling to the EU. Their money and their assets on EU bank accounts have been frozen. Products used to make chemical weapons, spying technologies, and certain types of arms produced in the EU cannot be sold to Syria. EU luxury goods cannot be exported to Syria. Cash and gold transfers to Syria's central bank are forbidden because they were used to finance the repression and profit from the war. At all times since sanctions were imposed in 2011, Syrians have still been able to buy food, medicines, and other goods produced in Europe. There is no economic war on Syria. Trade with Europe has continued throughout the war, and so did humanitarian aid and support to the population. EU sanctions have humanitarian exemptions built in. If a trustworthy humanitarian NGO want to bring chemicals into Syria for medical purposes, they just ask for an exemption, and they get it. We know this very well because we are the largest humanitarian donor to Syria. Two-thirds of the money spent to help the Syrians comes from the EU and its member states. We have provided almost 18 billion euros to Syrians since the beginning of the war. In food, shelter, health, and education, not in weapons. We provided assistance to keep hospitals and clinics operating while others bombed them. And we continue to bring assistance to Syria, including medical equipment needed to fight the coronavirus. EU sanctions are often wrongly blamed for shortages and the suffering of the population. This is what the main culprits say to cover for their taking money away from the Syrian people and profiteering from war, corruption, and poor economic management. Guess what? Many of them are under EU sanctions.